rider coach John Hange after a 36-6 win over GMU. Had kind of a started at 57, maybe a little bit of a slow start, but then you started reeling off bonus points. I haven't seen a technical disqualification for stalling in person in a while. Tell me a little bit about the team's performance. And
well, I feel like we were sharp. I feel like we were aggressive. I feel like we did what we needed to do to get, whether it's a win or whether it's bonus points, and just kind of go out there and do our thing. You know, so I'm really proud of the guys. Even in the losses, we wrestled hard. It's just continuing to build towards the end of the year. So,
good crowd, senior night. Tell me a little bit about the senior leadership on this team.
It's always tough to replace seniors. Yeah. This group has really taken ownership of this program. When we lost Chad to graduation, then somebody needed to step in, and it was kind of a collective whole.
Yeah.
And they're doing a great job as per the results that we've had this year, both individually and as a team. So it's always tough to lose that leadership and that investment that they've poured into the program, not just what coaches do, you know, individually and team-wise. So it's really special for them. We love them to death. We hate to lose them every year, but it's the process. You know? So it's good to learn from the younger guys to see how it's done and how it should be grown. So hopefully they passed on those lessons.
You guys have had some good wins. You knocked off Minnesota. You knocked off Virginia. We're getting a month away from conference championships. What are you focusing on from here to then?
Just getting better every day. Honestly, I know it's a little cliche, but it's realistically keeping it fun, keeping it hard because you got to stay sharp, but also keeping it in a learning environment. So we constantly are working on things. We're constantly doing individual work. We're constantly doing, you know, individual stuff outside so that we can just keep growing. And then when the group gets together, it's a lot of fun. We have a lot of fun in that room, but we also work our butts off, as you can see when we wrestle. So it's really just making sure we take one day at a time and just keep ourselves on point and just control what we can control, because we can't control what other people do, say, and, you know, anything like that. So it's really important that we just stay focused and real tunnel vision.
Now, all the matches are important, but you're hosting Rutgers here.
Yep.
First time in ever?
No, we've had them years ago. Yes.
When you were wrestling?
Not that long ago?
Not that long ago. Okay. Tell me a little bit. You look ahead at that. Like, they're drawing a ton of crowds. Looks like it's going to be a really competitive match.
It's obviously a highlight on our schedule, as it is, I'm sure, theirs. But it's not. Next is Lock Haven, and that's the focus. And the training for Lock Haven and Rutgers that weekend, it's a big weekend period.
Yeah.
We lost to both of those teams last year, so we have some things to correct on our end.
Yeah.
But it's just a matter of, if we look too far beyond and we make it too big of a, it's a big rivalry, let's be honest. New Jersey people want to see that.
Yeah.
And there's people out there who want to see us get our butts kicked. There's people who want to see them get their butts kicked, right? But we'll do our part, we'll prepare, we'll show up, and we'll see what happens.
Any special seating arrangements for that?
Yeah, there'll be different. The teams won't sit here, teams will sit over on the side.
Okay.
There'll be extra seating about 10 feet away.
Gotcha.
It'll be a little bit different of a diagram for sure.
Will I be able to get access?
You can sit wherever you want, Mike.
Well, I'm sitting with you guys.
My
Coach, thanks for the time.
Thanks.
Good luck.
Hey, thank you very much.